It's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful day today. The German Sustainable Building Council's acronym is DGNB. The DGNB is a non-profit and non-governmental organization whose mission is to develop and promote methods and solutions for sustainable design, construction, and management of buildings. The DGNB's work is centered on the establishment and development of a certification system for sustainable buildings and the award of a certificate in three levels of quality: gold, silver, and bronze. The company was founded in 2007 by 40 organizations from the construction and property industry. Worldwide, there are many sustainability certification systems that can measure the sustainability of a building, such as LEED in North America or BREEAM in the UK, as well as others. But for the purposes of this discussion, DGNB, LEED, and BREEAM will be discussed, as they are the three largest sustainability rating systems that use a third-party verification check. The widespread use of the LEED rating system makes it most familiar for North Americans. LEED literally stands for Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. That is a telling acronym because LEED certification is aimed at the ecological sustainability of a building, which is why the use of the word green is so often associated with a LEED building or building council. LEED certification means that the building is environmentally friendly and efficiently uses resources. This is good. The DGNB certification goes beyond that assessment and incorporates the full life cycle of a building in sustainability terms and places that in an economic category. Ecological and socio-cultural factors also have influence. And the system also takes into account the location quality in terms of technical and process merits. So Germans don't use the word green, it's sustainable. And it's a very important distinction that you will be corrected on. The DGNB has an international certification system because its system of certification can be adapted to country-specific differences by factoring in climatic and legal or structural requirements. So in cooperation with other non-profit and non-governmental organizations outside Germany, the DGNB certification system is adapted worldwide to the requirements in various regions. The Austrian Society for Sustainable Real Estate was the first to adapt and use the system in 2009. It recorded its first DGNB certified building in January 2010 in Canada. The Austria House at the Olympic Games in Vancouver was certified DGNB Silver. The Austria House was a 3,000 square foot home base for Austrian Olympic officials, media, and athletes during the Games. Rated at DGNB Silver, it is 90% more efficient than the average Canadian home. The DGNB also maintains a partnership with the Bulgarian Green Building Council, the DGNB China, the DGNB Hungary, the Swiss Society for Sustainable Real Estate Industry, and the Thai Society for Sustainable Building. In Brazil, Luxembourg, Russia, and Slovenia, cooperation memorandums are being produced, and most recently, Denmark has adopted the DGNB system after carefully looking at LEED, BREEAM, and DGNB. An interesting fact is that a LEED Platinum building does not necessarily meet DGNB Gold status. The DGNB Audit System. This system has five categories. Four categories are equally weighted at 22.5%. They are environmental quality, economic quality, socio-cultural and functional quality, and technical quality. Process quality accounts for the remaining 10% of the whole. The criterion distributed in these categories will generate a point score, which is expressed as a percentage at the end. If you score over 50%, it's a bronze. Over 65%, silver. Over 80%, gold. End of story. It's like the Olympics. Gold, silver, and bronze. Site quality is a separate category with its own specific evaluation criterion and a numeric assessment value which is listed separate from the other categories. This is done because it doesn't factor into a building's gold, silver, or bronze status, but the sum total of its evaluation is listed as a score.
A site quality factor might be exposure to an earthquake zone or something that one simply can't control about the site. So it's evaluated because it's valuable, but it won't factor into your building's evaluation because there was nothing one could do about it. It's evaluation on the site quality, which, when read in conjunction with the total assessment, gives a more holistic and thorough measurement. There are 51 specific individual criteria that the building is evaluated on and will generate a weighted mathematical points assessment. This chart shows how not all the criteria are equally distributed within the five categories. And when you look at the weightings of the individual criteria within the five categories, it's clear that there is an emphasis on certain factors. For example, there are only two criteria for economic quality, which indicates that from an economic point of view, life cycle and recyclability are very important. There are only five criteria for technical quality, which indicates that a building's technical performance is very important as well. Although not heavily weighted in the social, cultural, and functional quality, you could score points for the building design being the product of a design competition. You will also score points for winning a sanctioned design award. All of which is to say, there are incentives to make the building beautiful in this system for building sustainability. How do BREEAM, LEED, and DGNB compare? When you lay out all the possible aspects that BREEAM, LEED, and DGNB can use in their sustainability assessment, and you examine all the possible aspects by the level of demand asked by each system, one gets a feel for who is asking for what, and how much are they asking you to do. So let's look at how demanding BREEAM, LEED, and DGNB are with respect to all the possible aspects for measuring a building's sustainability. High demand is green, mid-level demand is yellow, low demand is red, not included is empty, included in the next version is blue. BREEAM covers all the aspects, but it is characterized primarily by mid-level demand. LEED is characterized by most aspects not being included, and what is included is either mid-level or low demand. DGNB, while it has two aspects that are not included, is characterized by high demand in all the present aspects. And when you see the three sustainability systems on the same chart, held to the same standards, even at a glance, the DGNB just appears most serious. How would the buildings compare? Moreover, where would the minimum representative building from LEED and BREEAM lie on a chart assessed against the DGNB criterion? Because the DGNB score is expressed as a percentage, the chart tops off at 100, and as mentioned, in the DGNB, bronze is above 50, silver is above 65, gold is above 80. So these volumes represent those values. This diagram shows the indicated buildings for their minimum numerical value, which would have earned them the rating that's noted at the top of the volume. The LEED Platinum volume is shown here at the minimum numerical value to be considered LEED Platinum and scored on the DGNB criterion and shown on the DGNB chart. Obviously, depending on the LEED Platinum building, it could be better than the minimum, but for comparison, all of these volumes represent the minimums to achieve the designation indicated. And that's why I was told that a LEED Platinum building does not necessarily equate DGNB Gold. DGNB auditors have explained to me that carefully constructing a building to minimum code requirements with a concentrated emphasis on the process quality will almost automatically earn you a bronze designation. This diagram illustrates where your basic standard code compliant building that's jumped through a few process hoops lies beside a LEED Silver building. Let's not forget about the Austria House from the 2010 Winter Olympics in Vancouver, which was rated a DGNB Silver and was 90% more efficient than the average Canadian home.